As you wander around the displays in the grand Hintze Hall, you may not notice the ceiling is a work of art. Known as the gilded canopy, the soaring vault is a golden cover adorned with 162 illustrated botanical ceiling panels showing plants from across the world. Many of the plants portrayed have medicinal uses. Some are ornamental, and others, like cotton, tea, and tobacco, were the plants that fueled the British Empire's economy. One of these is the plant Quassia amara, which the famous Swedish botanist Carl Linnaeus named after a former enslaved Ghanaian called Graman Kwasi. Kwasi was a healer and botanist who was enslaved as a child from Ghana and taken to Suriname, which was then a Dutch colony. Tending to both enslaved people and Europeans, he is viewed as a controversial figure. This is because he worked as a scout and negotiator for the Dutch to fight against the Saramaka Maroons, who were freedom fighters. Whilst the Saramaka Maroons branded him as a traitor, the Dutch celebrated him for his service. Controversy aside, he was a really important historical figure who discovered the plant Quassia amara in around 1730. Through his work as a healer, he found that the plant could be used to treat infections caused by intestinal parasites if drunk as a bitter tea. Quasi's secret formula for the tea was purchased for a considerable sum by Daniel Rolander, one of Linnaeus' students, who took it back with him to Europe in 1756. The sale of the medicine in part enabled Quasi to become so financially successful that he was able to buy his freedom. A specimen of the tree was later presented to Linnaeus in 1761 by Carl Gustav Dahlberg, a Swedish plantation owner in Suriname. Linnaeus publicly named and described the genus, thus establishing it within European botany. Examples of those specimens can be seen within his collections at the Linnaean Society in London. Quassia became a popular bitter, praised for its effectiveness in suppressing vomiting and removing fever in both the Caribbean and in the whole of Europe. Experiments by European physicians showed it to be as potent as Peruvian bark, but without the side effects such as diarrhea. Deemed safe and effective, Quassia was used in infusion, extract, or pills, and was included in various European pharmacopoeia. Incredibly, it continues to be used today in industrial-produced medicines for treating intestinal parasites. Quasi served during the next six decades as the colony's leading medicine man, with vast influence over all the inhabitants of Suriname, whether they were black, white, or indigenous peoples. In other accounts from the period, he is described as one of the most extraordinary black men in Suriname and perhaps the world. Thank you very much for watching this series. If you've enjoyed it, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe for more content from the Natural History Museum.